Hi, welcome back to Wesbury 101. I'm Brian Wesbury, Chief Economist at First Trust Portfolios. Remember, we want to be the antidote to conventional wisdom. Well, the chair and the vice chairman of the Federal Reserve Board, Janet Yellen and Stanley Fisher, are both in Jackson Hole, Wyoming today. And both of their speeches, which, by the way, are a lot longer than this video will be, said that the Fed could raise rates, and this is a paraphrase, in as early as September. I believe it's a big waste of time to worry about whether it's September, October, November, December, January. What's clear is that the Federal Reserve is going to lift rates. There are some people that still think the Fed's going to drop them to negative or do another round of QE. This is ridiculous. And let me tell you why this is true. The pressures to raise the federal funds rate will be persistent in the future. And our analysis is pretty simple. Take a look at this chart. It's the model we use of the Federal Reserve Board. It is a two-year annualized growth rate. That's the orange line of nominal GDP versus the federal funds rate. Remember, nominal GDP is real growth plus inflation. So we have about 2% real growth over the last few years, about 1.5% inflation over the last few years. That gives you roughly 3.5% nominal growth, which we've seen over the last 4, 5, 6 years. In fact, over the last 2 years, if you look at this chart, the orange line ends at 3.3%. Now, the reason this is important is because the federal funds rate over time should be equal or roughly equal to the growth rate of the overall economy. And as you can see from this chart, it's not always the case. And in fact, since the crisis in 2008, 2009, the Federal Reserve has held interest rates close to zero. Today, they're in a range of 0.25 to 0.5 of a percent, but that's well below the nominal GDP growth rate. And as a result, it's pretty easy to say that the Federal Reserve is accommodative today. It's easy in its policy, and interest rates should move up toward that nominal growth rate. And if they don't, inflation will slowly accelerate, and nominal GDP will accelerate as well. The reason long-term interest rates are as low as they are is because the Federal Reserve is artificially holding down the entire yield curve. When the Fed pushes the federal funds rate below nominal GDP, the only way they can do that is by being accommodative and promising to hold those rates low for a long period of time. What that does is it pulls the entire yield curve down. That's why today, as the Fed talks about raising interest rates, long-term interest rates will go up as well, because all these rates need to move back toward that nominal GDP target. There are many people out there who believe when the Fed lifts rates, it might invert the yield curve, that any rate hike is going to hurt the U.S. economy. Our model, comparing nominal GDP to the federal funds rate, shows that this is not true. If the Fed raises rates to 0.75%, to 1%, to 1.5%, they become less loose, but not tight. The only way the Federal Reserve will become tight is if they push the federal funds rate up to that nominal GDP line or above it. This is why I'm not worried about whether the Federal Reserve raises rates in September or October or December. It doesn't matter. They are so loose today that a small rate hike is not going to make a difference. One last point, and that is that today, because of the Federal Reserve's quantitative easing programs, there are $2.25 trillion of excess reserves in the system. The Federal Reserve typically, in order to raise interest rates, will withdraw some of those reserves, make reserves scarce, and that's the way rates go up. But this time, this tightening cycle is different than any other we've seen in the history of the Federal Reserve, and that is they're just announcing that rates will be higher. They're going to pay more on those excess reserves, but they aren't subtracting any of those reserves from the system. And that's why a rate hike is not getting tight, first of all, but the second thing to remember is that it's not subtracting any excess reserves from the system. The Federal Reserve is a long way from being tight, and therefore a long way from causing any kind of slowdown or recession in the U.S. economy. Final point, this is all great news for financials. Financial stocks are cheap. And as the Federal Reserve raises rates, not only will banks earn more on their excess reserves, but long-term rates will go up, which means they will earn more on loans. I believe that as the Federal Reserve lifts rates, financial stocks will rise and eventually go back to long-term values, which are significantly higher than they were where they are today. I love financial stocks at this point in the business cycle. I also believe that the Fed is a long, long way from actually harming the economy by raising rates. But they do need to lift rates, and if they don't, inflation will slowly but surely get out of control. Thanks so much for visiting Wesbury 101. We'll see you next time.